Large-scale explorations beyond our planet provided as the dramatic backdrop for the post-nuclear era power struggle between the U.S. and the Soviet Union during the height of the Cold War. This uneasy tension propelled new technology, gave rise to space agencies, and laid the groundwork for future developments in almost every mechanical facet of our life in the early years of the space race. The U.S. and what is now Russia have long been the two space industry titans, but there is a new competitor in the modern space race. China will complete construction on the Tiangong space station, also known as the Heavenly Palace, later this year. It will be the nation's first outpost in space. The first phase of the multi-module station was launched by the Chinese National Space Administration more than 10 years ago. According to the agency, Tiangong station will be China's most daring space venture. In today's video, Elon Musk provides an update while we look at China's remarkable efforts to construct its own space station and the future of space under its leadership in the coming years. Hey everyone, welcome back to Elon Musk Evolution, where we bring you the most recent news about Elon Musk and his multi-billion dollar companies, space news, and the latest science and technology. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss any of our amazing videos. According to Musk, the U.S. government will reflect on its 2011 decision to forbid Chinese astronauts from the International Space Station, when China soon has the only operational space station in the entire cosmos. One of the basic concepts of space exploration is that it should be a collaborative endeavor from nations. Chinese astronauts are not permitted to use the ISS, according to the U.S. government. China was practically forced to build an entirely new space station from scratch after the U.S. forced them into a corner and gave them no other choice, Musk stated. The U.S. has controlled space and directed the global effort to construct the ISS, but the ISS is nearing its end. By 2031, it will have reached the end of its life cycle and be decommissioned. You might be wondering why space exploration is so crucial. Why do we need to explore space when we already have so many issues on Earth? We wouldn't have GPS, precise weather forecasts, solar cells, ultraviolet filters, cameras, or sunglasses without space mission, Musk explained. China intends to control the future of space since space exploration has significantly improved life on Earth. China's space dream under President Xi Jinping has seen a major unprecedented growth in planning. China also intends to construct a base on the moon and send astronauts there by 2030 in addition to developing its own space station. As you can see, Musk stated, China was compelled to build its own space station. For nearly 20 years, China has expressed a keen interest in taking part in the ISS, but the U.S. administration opposed China's proposals in each case in 2011. The Wolf Amendment, sponsored by Republican Frank Wolf, prevents NASA from cooperating with China in space exploration despite the ISS being operated by an international effort that is transparent and cooperative. China was the only country to which the United States specifically said, China just can't. When questioned about why the U.S. administration adopted this hardline position, the U.S. administration announced it had made a decision to interdict China over human rights and national security issues. The American administration has previously exploited human rights as a tactic to restrict foreign nations. But let's be honest, how would banning Chinese astronauts influence the situation? Do ISS astronauts work to advance human rights in any way? Researchers merely desire to collaborate with other intelligent researchers. They are able to keep political differences out of their employment. Also, let's be open about the fact that if a nation's record on human rights is the criterion for entry to the ISS, we should also forbid American astronauts. In contrast, however, to how the U.S. views forbidding China, the communist country responds to international collaboration. The Chinese government has said it will continue to open to global cooperation. Tiangong will be the only independent space station once it is operational, in contrast to the ISS. China was the fifth country in the world to launch a satellite into space successfully toward the close of the 20th century. But its list of successful space ventures has been surprisingly full in the decades before Tiangong. According to Musk, a powerful satellite navigation network that can compete with the GPS system supported by the U.S., an unmanned Mars probe, and Chang'e 4, the first craft to explore the far side of the moon, have all been made possible by China's frantic efforts to expand the scope of their space activities in recent years. Future robotic explorations of the southern pole of Earth's satellite may be made possible by the discoveries made by the semi-autonomous U-2-2 rover, which was the robotic probe's companion. Likewise, as more private companies start to launch new vehicles, like cargo spacecraft and other satellites, the country's commercial space industry is starting to flourish. A fully autonomous space station might serve as a springboard for upcoming projects, launching scientific research to new altitudes and advancing China's long-standing goal of sending taikonauts, the Chinese equivalent of NASA astronauts, to the moon eventually. Tiangong will be noticeably smaller and have a smaller personnel capacity than the ISS, despite the fact that the station will serve as a launch pad for several anticipated projects. Despite these limitations, the vessel will have more than enough space to carry out extremely crucial scientific research. Over 1,000 experiments will be carried out on the station over the course of its existence once it is operational, many of which were proposed by scientists around the world. According to Musk, what is evident is that many of China's projects adhere to a deliberate pattern of copying what has already been accomplished and using the lessons learnt by their rivals to progress and enhance their own designs. The Russian Mir space station, which spent nearly 15 years in orbit before disintegrating over the southern Pacific Ocean in 2001, is one example of a space station that seems practically identical from the outside. China's historical problems with uncontrolled rocket debris will also need to be properly addressed if the agency intends to encourage sustainable space exploration as the Earth's atmosphere starts to fill up with more and more human-made debris. The nation is still the only one to test experimental space debris mitigation devices, despite the fact that there are no plans in the open as to how the country would deal with these issues moving forward. Currently, NASA is prohibited from working with China or companies that are owned by China, given that any international scientific initiative would at least partially be led by the U.S., future cooperation between Tiangong and the ISS is likewise extremely unlikely. China might be reluctant to join a partnership that the U.S. has so much control over, given the U.S. propensity to take the lead in its foreign activities. But according to Musk, the station is extremely enticing to many other partners that don't have such sophisticated space programs. Not only underdeveloped nations looking to play a minor or supporting role, but also major European nations can discover rewarding areas of cooperation with China. Nevertheless, even while China may be lagging behind and embracing the do's and don'ts of responsible space operations, many in the political and scientific world are optimistic that as the country's presence in space increases, they'll start to catch on. And that ends our episode. We hope that you enjoyed the video. What do you think of this episode? Will the United States allow China to dominate space? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section below. Please subscribe and don't forget to like today's video. We'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Thanks.